Robots taking the sports field, but not how you may think.
Rich DeMuro explains in today's Rich on Tech. Good morning. How are you?
Hey, good morning to you guys. Doing well. Happy Wednesday.
Happy Wednesday to you.
We've seen a lot of instances of robots kind of taking over.
Right.
But these robots literally rushing the field and quite literally, they are painting lines. This is happening at Cal Lutheran University. It's all part of a growing trend where robots are now being used to paint field lines for sports fields. The process is faster and more accurate than ever.
At this university, robots are storming the field.
This is a real big leap,
mm-hmm.
where we are actually replacing some of the things that humans would do and actually doing it better.
They're not playing sports, but prepping for them.
We were convinced immediately.
Ryan Van Omeren has been with Cal Lutheran University for 25 years. Recently, the school adopted several robots that can autonomously paint field lines.
So when we learned of the robot, I knew right away that this is something that we could use and take a burden off our groundskeepers.
Pulling strings, measuring, getting those right angles exactly the way they're supposed to, and the robot really eliminates a lot of the need for, you know, some of that manual labor.
The turf tank, as it's called, uses GPS and Wi-Fi for precise lines every time.
The robot's accurate within a centimeter.
Basically, this tablet is going to be the brain of the operation.
Just load the robot with special chalk paint for fields, choose a design, and off it goes.
We've got soccer, lacrosse, football, rugby. There's so many different designs that it can paint.
Soccer lines that used to take 2 to 3 hours now take 20 minutes. A football field that might have taken 2 days now takes a few hours. The robots use less paint and are more efficient at field changes, making them popular.
Everybody from the NFL down to your local AYSO club.
But are these bots pulling a fast break on human jobs?
What about the human jobs that this is displacing or changing?
So a human being still has to run the robot, right? Although it does line the fields autonomously, somebody has to be there to maintain the equipment, to run the tablet, to fill the paint, just like you would with your regular walk behind equipment.
Those lines look sharp. The robot costs anywhere between $6,000 and $16,000, but most customers rent them. And right now, the robots can only paint one color at a time. Perhaps in the future, the model will be able to handle multiple colors at once. All right, richontech.tv if you want to learn more about the bot. Kind of a good idea.
Yeah.
No, it's sort of an obvious idea in a way. I mean, it's using technology to do something that, you know, is sort of drudgery for a lot of people, you know?
Yeah.
And the lines always looked a little bit wavy, and now they're even, I don't know.
Now
and
they're perfect.
On the flip side, you can turn the field over quicker.
Right.
So you can actually, for like
change.
A school, you can maybe make more money renting it out for different events, which is, you know.
Interesting.
The sell.
Yeah.
Thank you, Rich.
And shout out to Cal Lutheran, Thousand Oaks.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Love it out there.
Your hometown.
So nice.
Grew up
exactly.
around there.
Absolutely. And it's been amazing to watch the campus and the school become a
very
much
nice
bigger
campus.
Deal. Yeah.
I went to a coffee place just out there, Longevity Coffee.
Oh,
and
Thousand
I had,
Oaks?
Yeah, in Thousand
in
Oaks.
T.O. as they call it.
Yeah, T.O. Right. As I usually call it.
Right.
Yeah.
Of course.
But it was great.
Only
just
the
sat
cool
there.
Kids.
Yeah, and just had an acai bowl.
Okay.
Yeah.
Did it add some longevity to your life? Too?
I hope so. It was very healthy.
Yeah.
We can't tell yet.
I think we're on the path, though. So things are looking up.
They are.
We're tracking.